Hello my friends and welcome to Open Studio D, and today our conversation will be, is it okay to work with the images or photograph in your daily paintings? Is it okay to use the photograph or images to paint from? So this will be our talk, so let's get started.
Here we go!
The question that is widely asked on mostly every workshop that I took or I participated in is this: is it okay to paint from photographs? Is it okay to use the images to paint from? And I think this question is too wide or too broad to just simply say yes or no. So if you ask me right now this question, I will say yes and I will say no, because actual question is wrong. So I think what we should do, we should break this question into sub questions just to eliminate the problems and get to the question that we can 100% say yes or no. So the first question will be probably, just to simplify the question if it's okay to use the images. So I think the question should sound like this: is it okay to use images or photographs as a reference for my daily workflow? And the key word in this question will be as a reference. As a reference, only reference. And my answer will be yes, absolutely. So historically, we know a lot of famous artists in the history of art using photos or images that they created as a reference for their paintings. The names like Paul Cézanne, Van Gogh, Toulouse-Lautrec, Edgar Degas, and many other famous artists, painters were using photographs, and we have a proof of it. And this was a time when actually photography, black and white photography, just evolved, and those artists jumped on the use of the cameras. All of them, most of them had a camera in their hands, and most of them had their studios to where they compose some shots, and then they're using photography or photos as a reference for their future paintings. For example, Norman Rockwell, famous American illustrator that became an iconic artist in the United States, he had his own photography studio where he was working in composition, taking a lot of shots, and there is actual video. You can find those video even on YouTube, how he was working his studio using different devices and different things to compose his structure of the painting, and then taking the photographs as a reference and working as a reference. And by the way, the photographs were black and white, but he was using it as a reference for his main kind of paintings. The history is loaded with those artists using photographs as a reference, and keyword is as a reference. So if they were using, like, we cannot use it. When mobile device evolves like this, the iPhone or Android or any other mobile devices where with the screen and ability to take photographs and look at right away, we jump on it, and this is absolutely okay. We should jump on this because this is extra tools that we have in our hands. So using a photograph or images as a reference, again, keyword is a reference, is yes. Absolutely yes. You not only as a permission can use, you should use. It's a highly recommended device to use for your daily painting because it will help you a lot. There's a lot of tools that you can use to just ease your workflow or get better. So the answer to if it's okay to use images or photographs in your daily workflow is yes, with a keyword as a reference to your paintings. As the only reference to your daily painting. And question number two will be, is it okay to use the images or photographs that doesn't belong to you, that belongs to someone else? And the answer is absolutely no. Absolutely big no, N-O. I'll give you several reasons why it's big N-O, no. So reason number one, why it's no. All the images from main online galleries like iStock, PhotoStocks, Flickr, and there is a bunch of other galleries. All those images are copyrighted. So basically they have a copyright on every image. If you download that image and you use it, there is a rule. What is the copyright rule? you cannot copy it. So if you're copying using this image and copying to your painting, it's a copying, right? You're doing copy. So it's a big no. It's because you'll be, you know, facing legal actions against you doing wrong thing, copying the image. So big no. You know, that's a reason number one why not to use someone's images, especially downloading from the internet. So big no. Copywriting, okay? And the reason number two, do not mark yourself as a copy maker. And I will explain you what does it mean, copy maker, being a copy maker. Let's use some example. Let's say you downloaded the image from Flickr, really great image of landscape, and you decide, okay, let's make some, you know, some painting, let's do some work. You finish that work, you put it on your website, and somehow one of the collectors got to your site and he's like, wow, that's interesting. And you start conversation. Most collectors, they have their art advisors and they will do some research and they will find that you actually, there's a photograph on the Flickr or somewhere that, you know, identical to your painting. You will be marked as a copy maker. So you basically, you will end up in a dead end as an artist, I guarantee you. So only work with your own images. And this is reason number two, not to work with the images that doesn't belong to you, all right? And the reason number three, why it's no, big no, to work with the images that doesn't belong to you. Most of the images online on all these famous galleries or stock images are iconic images, iconic photographs from iconic scenery. What does mean iconic scenery? It's a famous scenery that is easy to sell. You know, or a view on the mountains, a view on some, you know, bridges, some buildings, some landscape, famous landscape that every photographer just going because if somebody got, you know, shot of that scenery or that barn somewhere in Tennessee, and you know that image is selling like crazy, trust me, a bunch of photographers will go and start shooting the same barn from the same view. That's how it works. So if you see this, all those images online and it's like, wow, it's interesting, maybe I should do the painting of this, please avoid, because you're going to mark yourself as what we call calendar type of artist. What is a calendar type of artist? $50, $60, maybe $100 per painting. That's it, because you're a calendar type of artist. So please avoid using iconic scenery. There is a bunch, I have a video actually, the beauties around us, literally 15, 20 minutes away in the radius of your house, you can find something interesting to paint. Painting is not the scenery, painting is the mood. Painting is your voice, what you're trying to say, all right? So avoid painting these iconic sceneries. So this is reason number three. And the reason number four is very simple, but probably the main reason why to avoid using images that doesn't belong to you. And it's very simple. What if you take your camera or you take your phone and you're working with the scenery that you're experiencing and you want to paint? You basically attaching yourself. Your mind is, you know, taking a million snapshots of this scenery and putting in the memory. You feel the smell, you feel the wind, you feel the atmosphere, the air, you know, the everything around, even something in the car passing by, you will remember it. So when you take the photograph, it's not only the photograph digital, you know, pixels in your photo, it's actually the memory. And this is the most important thing for art, for the artist, for us to paint, to use the image as a reference, because the reason why. Because when you pull that photograph to paint, to work on from your camera or from your computer, you're not only looking at the image, your memory, your mind is pulling all that information from inside of you about this image, about this scenery. And you painting not what you see on the image, you painting what you feel from inside. And this is what we call attachment to that scenery or attachment to that image. So you're going to say something about this scenery, about this, you know, motif that you're going to paint, and using image as a reference, the key word as a reference, okay? And you, the main point is you attach. Do not use the images that you didn't take. It doesn't belong to you. right? Because you have no attachments. Those paintings, I guarantee you, those paintings that you will make from these photographs will be dead. You know, there is no feelings, there is no attachments. Maybe they will look great, but they will be dead. And all the collectors, all galleries, museums, they will see it. You will see it later on that it's dead. Four main reasons why not to use the photographs or images that doesn't belong to you. Not only that doesn't belong to you, that you didn't take. And now we're moving to the next question. Is it okay to use the photographs or images that belongs to me or belongs to you, that I took or you took, right? And the answer is absolutely yes. Y-E-S, yes. And the reason why, the first and one main reason why to use it, you should allocate some days when you take your camera or you take your mobile device and you go somewhere and just, today is my day when I will just go take photographs. Don't take your easel, because sometimes you find something and you want to paint and you just spend time just one scenery and your bank of images is there, it's not there. So I would recommend just allocating one day when it's, you know, good weather, you know, jump in your car and start driving to parks, to local, you know, local parks, local, I don't know, sceneries around. You just driving, and like if you see something, just stop and take a photo. Take a photos, and I will show you in the next video. I will explain you how to work with the images, how actually work with the images, how to build your library, how to select the images from that library, and how to move them to the next stage when you can actually work with those images as a reference to the paintings and convert them to the paintings, to your artwork, okay? So that will be all for today. Unfortunately, there is no demo, just talk for today, but I hope this will be informative. And if you used to this channel, please subscribe, hit the bell, hit the like, and stay tuned, because a lot of videos are coming, how to work with the images, how to build a library, and so on and so on. And if you are already subscribed, thank you very much from my heart for supporting my channel and watching my videos. I will see you next time.